Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'll be making a card using this stamp set by the Alleyway Stamps. So I'll start here by stamping my images. I'm using my Metto Tuxedo Black ink, and I'm just stamping the leaf three times. I'll then go ahead and stamp the egg. This is a cute dinosaur egg, which I'm going to stamp twice, and then I'll stamp my dinosaur. I'll be coloring my images using my Prismacolor pencils. So here is my set here. And I'll also need my Gamsol, which is a mineral spirit, as well as my blending tool. So I have these stamps here, as well as this sanding block. This sanding block actually helps me to clean the tips of my stamps. And I just sand it there, or you can also use your scissors and cut the tip, if you think that's easier for you. So I'll just keep my tips nice and pointy, and now I can go ahead and color in my images. Now, coloring images with colored pencils like Prismacolor, I think it's very easy to do, and it's not as overwhelming as with Copics. So I just apply my first color there. I am not pressing too hard. I just want to make sure that my lighter color goes all over the image. Then I'll use a second color to add my shading, and then I'll go over and add a third color, darker one, to add even more shading. Once everything is there, I'll then use my blending tools and Gamsol to blend everything together. I'll speed up the process and catch you up once my images are ready. One of the things that I love about coloring images with my Prismacolor pencils is that I don't have to move fast, so that all my layers of colors stay wet and easy to blend. I can go ahead and apply color as slow as I want and think about it, and then the Gamsol does the difficult work of blending. So now I'll just I'm using two pieces of scrap paper here that I found on my stash. I want the blue and a green one, just to create my scene there, so for the sky and the grass. And I'm also using this notepad page die, which I think is by Penny Black. And now I can go ahead and assemble my main focal point of the card. So I'll just go ahead and stick the grass at the bottom, but first I make sure that the curve is the other way. And now I want to make sure that that's not too long of a notepad page, so I'll make sure that after I stick it down, I'll cut off just a strip from the bottom. So I'm using my Fiskars trimmer here. This is a Fiskars trimmer that I really love. I have it for years, and I have to say that I've been changing blades like once every 6 months or something. And now I have this speech bubble die, which is also by Penny Black. I'm just cutting out a bubble from white cardstock, and now I can go ahead and stamp this dinosaur saying. So it says roar, and now I'm ready to assemble my card. Now I'll use foam squares at the back of all my pieces just to add some dimension. You know that I love dimension on my cards. I think it adds just a bit of something interesting on them. I'm sticking one of the leaves down, and the other two are I'm sticking them using foam squares. I'm also sticking down the two eggs and the speech bubble. But first I'll stick the notepad page on my cardstock. This is a cardstock, this is craft cardstock, and I've cut it down to create a standard card. So that's 4.25 by 5.5. And now I'll go ahead and stamp the sentiment. I'm actually going to combine two of the sentiments that are in this stamp set, and I'll be using the that means from this sentiment, so I'm masking off the rest of it, and I'll go ahead and white emboss it at the front and the very bottom of my card, and on the inside I'll stamp from another sentiment, I'll stamp the saying that says miss you in dinosaur. So I did just a bit of masking on my sentiments there just to create the sentiment that I really wanted. So I'm heat setting my sentiment there. It says that means, and I'm using my white gel pen to add 3 dots so that the recipient knows that something is inside the card that completes the sentiment. So I've stamped also on the inside and white embossed the miss you in dinosaur. Now my card is almost finished, so I can add some finishing touches. This is enamel accents in white, and I'll just add some dots here and there on his body, as well as on the eggs. And while I was doing that, I had the feeling that that dinosaur was screaming for a googly eye, so I had to add that as a final touch. And I'll go ahead and use my tacky glue to stick a googly eye there. And I guess the card is finished. So I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel, as well as leave me a comment. Thank you all for watching.